way you want.
It's pretty cool stuff going on in here.
Either way works out pretty well.
Yeah. All right, let's go talk to this guy. Uh-huh. Hello, friend. Yes.
That one, and then the sword, and up in that one.
And the Great Sword of Judgment. It said both of his swords. Yeah. Ceremonial sword held in Sullivan's left hand, representing the judgment of the moon, but with magic far closer to sorcery than any existing lunar power. Its dark blue hues, deeper than the darkest moon, reflect Sorcerer Sullivan's true nature. So, yeah, he's a sorcerer,
mm-hmm.
man, stance of judgment, assume stance and leech dank magic, use normal attack for lunging thrust and strong attack that emit side sweeping wave. Ceremonial sword in the right hand, representing the profaned flame. Long ago when Sullivan was a young sorcerer, he discovered the profane capital and an unfading flame below a distant tundra of Irithyll, and a burning ambition took root within him.
So this also gives us some timeline. The profane capital and Yorm existed before Sullivan and Aldrich and this all became
and
a thing.
And shit.
So it seems to give us that Yorm linked the fire before Aldrich's cycle.
It's like, oh, yeah. Hmm.
This weapon's pretty cool because its weapon art is if you L trigger and then do a right trigger attack, it does like the heavy attack, and then you get a flame buff for a while.
Well, yeah.
It's a pretty cool weapon.
Huh. But the profane flame is unfading.
Yes, it was unable to be stopped.
Yeah.
I'm still like looking at stuff. We can probably find out more as we do this playthrough.
Yeah.
To figure out really more about the
but
profane flame.
But that sounds interesting. That sounds like something that could be, I don't know, useful.
Oh, champion, do you wish to hear a tale?
Yeah, you got anything to say?
No, she won't until there's still actually one more tome to find.
Yeah,
quite far along the path, actually.
Okay, so she's got plenty of time to just sit around being blind and shit.
Basically.
Still blind and shit! Oh, you got
she won't take those. He won't take those, remember?
Yeah, I forgot.
One's too dank and the other one's for ladies.
Yeah. One's for ladies.
Talk to Yuri. I think she now has new dialogue.
There were more special.
And it's fun because if you go the way that I know you want to go, you will actually get more of this quest line quicker.
Okay.
But again, the choice is up to you. Yeah, I think she has the new
fucking
dialogue.
Explain things to me.
Here it is, yeah.
Good tidings. My spouse is ready. The time is right to greet her. The girl awaits thee in the hidden dark moon chamber of Anor Londor.
Excuse me? Excuse me?
My smug expression while drinking tea does not play over audio, but that's what's happening right now.
Why did they put her in the dark moon chamber? Why is that where we're supposed to go to do the thing, to do the bad thing?
Honestly, it seems like, completely, considering where this leads you ending-wise, it seems very symbolic, actually. But, yeah, so, if you go to Pontiff Sullivan, you can go forward that way, or you can go to the Distant Man. I know which way you're going.
Yeah, I'm gonna go peek, take a little peek.
The zones are pretty equal in difficulty, so it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, I'm gonna look through this door and see what... Anything cool going on? What you got going on?
Well,
over
the
here?
First thing you'll see is where the best PvP, where the hot, the hypest PvP spot in the game is.
Yeah.
Also, that cool shit in the distance you can't go to for a while.
Hmm.
Optional area.
Yeah.
Two crystal lizards are down there.
That's, this is a PvP area.
Uh huh, yeah.
Fuck.
It's a pretty good dueling arena. I've taken a part in many duels and fight clubs here. Unfortunately, Dropout Dragon's playing on PS4, so I couldn't be part of his fight clubs he's been running on his streams. But what you want to see, pan your camera to the right.
Hold on, I'm...
Exterior collision yourself.
Yeah, grabbing things and stuff. Stuff and things.
Yeah, so that's where you came from. Oh! Oh, that's right. You're also in an auto-invade spot.
As I said, a dank moon place or something?
Not dank moon. So go ahead and pan up. Still looking forward.
What do they usually pop up from here?
Oh, well, no, I was actually directing you to the environment, but... Oh, this isn't even auto-invade. This is just Red Spirit. Duel, duel, duel. Oh, he's giving a vow. The etiquette has begun. Maximum honor. Oh, he's a finger. Ooh. He's got a set... Oh, man, this is basically a mirror.
Mirror match, yeah.
This is actually... Yeah, this is... That's Black Knight.
Okay, so he's got thrust shit going on.
Yeah, I'm not a huge fan of the Black Knight sword, though.
Yeah,
like, it's not bad.
I don't care much for it either.
This is interesting, though, because you're both playing with, yeah.
Yeah, just beating on each other.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's
you got too greedy.
Well, he's got way better armor on than me, too. I don't have... Oh!
No, he
doesn't.
You
know what? You know what? You know what it is? I put on that ring. That improves your iframes, but lowers your defense.
I didn't know.
That's why I died instantly.
I forgot you put that on.
Yeah, to dodge the ball.
That explains some of the hits you've been taking.
Yeah.
But,
I had that on.
But now, what you want to see is you want to go out and go to the left and pan your camera
up. And pan my camera up. Oh.
It's just.
So this is just Anne Orlando.
Yes.
So what the fuck happened, though?
This was built up. You're actually not in the old Anne Orlando proper. This seems to have stemmed from the city that was here. That's the second half.
Of?
Anne Orlando.
Yeah, but that's the
cathedral where you fight Orstein and Smough.
Yeah. So then...
This was
used to be all city down here.
And it was built differently now. It
yeah,
seems
but then,
like
there was so much over this way and shit. Like, there was buildings way beyond.
Don't worry.
Like the mountain's, like, been, like, just destroyed over time. Like, it's
different. The thing is, like, we've been over cycles and cycles, so...
Yeah.
It's,
but then also, like, this is a twisted, like, shit.
But,
like,
time and space are convoluted in Lordran.
Yeah, because, like, some of these places seem to be, like, a collision of...
Other places,
lands, like,
yeah,
have been warped together.
So that's the other thing is time and space are both convoluted here.
Yeah. So the giants showed up.
Yeah.
They tried to battle fight
a little bit.
Yeah, that's just Anne Orlando
yeah.
right there.
And that's if you're gonna go down this path, you're heading that way.
Yeah. Let's do that. I'm interdasted. Are you all dead? You got fucked up, bro. You got fucked hard.
Mm-hmm. Got some good hits in though, right?
I don't know. Don't look that way.
There's an item back in that corner.
All right. So I can do this again.
Yes. You no longer need to parry. Yeah. So this is an area that if you're Ember, there is a covenant. You can actually join it here. We'll go to where we need to for it. It's kind of hidden. But you can join a covenant here. It's the Aldrich Faithful Covenant. And,
okay, so he's got
his own thing. And it's another auto-invade covenant, so anytime anyone gets here,
yeah,
it'll pull you in. And man, does it pull you in way more than Watch Dogs.
Yeah.
It's kind of depressing.
What the fuck is going on?
You're just in Lordran.
Yeah.
This is just Lordran
after
millennia.
Thousands of years, yeah, but like...
And some of it survived better than other parts.
But then, like, so, like, the dark sky. Maybe it's not a time thing.
Maybe it's just...
It's that the illusion is gone, and, like, that's the reason this place is frozen, too, is that...
Everything is, yeah.
A million pyromancers.
Yeah, there's a bunch of deacons up there.
Yeah.
You can get up there without going straight forward. You can go another way.
Drang?
Yeah.
Bro.
Yeah, there's a couple NPCs down here. And a giant that's not dead.
Huh. Smart.
Yeah, there's two NPCs here.
Why are the Drang guys... There was one at the cathedral.
Yeah, they seem to have some kind of connection with the cathedral.
Yeah, like they went there, and then, like, what, did they bring Aldrich here or something? Or are they hunting Aldrich? Or...
It seems like they might be hunting him.
Why are you guys using, like, dark weapons and shit? Fuck Dragon Lake, like, doing that kind of shit.
Well, who the fuck knows what happened to Dragon Lake after all the
bullshit
went down?
Yeah, the undead of that one took the throne and...
And then, of course, there's the fact that, like...
Throne.
And then, well, there's also the fact of, like, Nashandra was a fragment of Manus,
yeah.
So they could be more
okay,
with her.
Okay, so I just have to say the guy on the right just looks like Jon Snow.
Oh, my God, I know.
He's
I know.
Just
Yo,
Jon Snow.
You aren't wrong. You aren't even wrong. It's so funny. He just looks like Kit Harington, Jon Snow. It's
yeah.
great. Men of the Wall. It's okay, they're NPCs, so even if he kills you, his buddy's dead.
Yeah. I just don't want him taunting my corpse.
Yeah, the drying weapons are pretty good.
Yeah. Did you know that dual wielding is the theme of Drang?
Well,
Dying,
they also
apparently?
Their buffs are pretty good.
Yeah. Drang twin spear. They go Drang, Drang.
You're clanging them together.
Pair of spears of the Drang Knights proclaimed descendants of the land, known for the legend of the Linking of the Fire. When Drang Knights disbanded, they scattered across the lands to sell swords. They quickly became known for shieldless aggressive tactics that struck fear in the hearts of man. But, yeah.
So you can head straight, or if you go to the left, you can go up the stairs and you can deal with all the deacons without them firing you.
Yeah.
And there's,
You're fired!
And there's an item that you can wrap around to, and a, like, a quote-unquote shortcut, an easier run,
yeah,
if you do an immediate 180. Around. You want to go in there.
Oh, and they're not even regular deacons, they're big fat men.
Yeah, they're fuckmen. Yeah, that leads right back down to the Pontiff bonfire. There's a lizard over there.
Yeah.
I think there might be a chest up there too. But yeah, so now this way you can if you would
just come back this way. And
yeah, because there's also the covenant for Aldrich faithful is sort of hidden, and in order to get it, you have to go through one of the toughest non-boss encounters in the game.
Yeah.
And it's an encounter I honestly really dislike, though. To be fair, I am actually I'm actually right here.
You're a mimic. Just a mimic.
Yeah, that's just a mimic. To be fair, I'm actually right here with my pure strength build, so I haven't done it with this weapon yet, so it might be better for you. But it's still kind of fucked.
Oh god.
The roundhouse.
He's doing tattoos.
The fucking noises, they're so goofy, they're so silly. Was his tongue wagging back and forth and shit?
Oh, he Goomba stomped me.
You're fine. It's fine.
It's fine. Everything's fine.
Oh, that sucks. Oh, that sucks.
No. No Chuck Norris shit. Fuck out of here. Fucking Christ. That noise is so... Golden ritual spear, huh? It's golden. It's a ritual.
It's a spear.
It's a spear.
Bottom left.
There it is. A ritual spear presented to Dark Moon Knight before Sullivan claimed the title of Pontiff. Can also be used as a staff. Sorceries cast using this weapon channel the Weirdo's faith.
So, that's the thing. He locked a deity of the old royalty up in the old cathedral.
Yeah.
He's using sorcery, it's not Dark Moon magic.
Yeah.
It's clear that he's going against what Anor Londo used to be.
Yeah.
Whereas there was a time where there was still some civilization that held it as an actual authority.
Yeah, Gwendolyn was still around.
Yeah.
And what is the Devourer?
Aldrich.
Oh.
Remember how
he devours men.
And then I think there's something, I forget if it's something we've picked up yet or not, but it talks about him deciding to devour gods instead.
No, I haven't seen that yet.
Okay, no, he's talking about Aldrich.
That ain't great. Lizard ahead. That's a good message.
Well, it's not. It's
simple gem.
It removes scaling.
Yeah.
Or something like, I forget what it is. It does something weird. I never used it.
It makes weapons simple.
Yes.
It removes all buttons except for one.
It makes them dumb. Yeah, the thing about... what the fuck was I even talking about? It's a good question, Anthony. Whatever.
Aldrich eating things.
Yeah, I guess I was talking about... Oh, no, I was talking about the messages.
Yeah.
It's funny, because it's got that double thing. Is like, there are people who are assholes with messages, and that can be hilarious. But then there's, like, the genuine, like, helpfulness that you can provide for people.
And then there's some of the illusionary wall there.
Yeah, don't worry about it. It's fine.
Ooh, Gwendolyn got it hard.
Uh-huh.
Oh.
The law is deal.
I mean, yeah, granted, I guess most people didn't fight Gwendolyn.
Well, that's the thing. And, like, while there's lore that I do like, some of it I'm iffy with. And I do, and I mean, you know, it's out of the bag now anyway, so we'll talk about it. Like, it talks about Gwendolyn. I am iffy on the fact that they imply that the canon choice is that you don't kill Gwendolyn.
Yeah.
Well,
I mean, I have to imagine most people never fought Gwendolyn.
Because they don't know.
It's obscure. And, and you just don't know. Most people just don't find it.
Yeah, so I mean, no, it makes sense that, like, it couldn't. And again, time is convoluted.
Where the fuck are you? What are you?
Oh, that's a fun area we won't get to for a while. That area houses my favorite boss in the game.
Yeah. I'm just trying to figure out in respect to where...
Oh, that's far...
I don't think anything was that way.
No, that's a new thing. That's a new thing.
Yeah.
That's a new secret thing. Yeah, that is new. But see,
fucking weird spatial convolutedness is fucking stupid.
And this also is why I have reason to believe that there's a chance the catacombs are Sense Fortress.
Yeah.
Because you go through the catacombs and end up in Anorlion.
Yeah, oh yeah, all the areas beforehand seem to have been, like...
Yeah. Yeah.
But then that Lothric, though, isn't...
Lothric is new.
Lothric's over there. That's a whole nother...
It's where the homes converge.
Yeah.
And, of course, there's the fact of, And I don't remember if we hit the item description that says or not. There's an item description that talks about, that the high wall of Lothric just appeared.
Yeah, one day it was just there.
So, like, that's the whole, like... Space is also kind of convoluted here. But Lothric is supposed to be where it converges, so it's almost like a central hub kind of thing. Yeah, you can just get the items.
Not even a super huge giant. You're just a regular giant.
He's just a derpy giant. Yeah, he's...
Or a bad giant.
He's not a problem.
Well, I mean, when he backhands you at half health.
Yeah, he can kill you, but he's not, like, inherently a problem.
So much. Now there's so much going on.
Well, so that, and that's the thing. Like, before you're like, wow, this feels like it was Ulusteel and Darkroot, and wow, this looks like weirdly like Sense Fortress.
And now, wow, there's just a big sign painted right there that says, welcome to Anorlondo.
Yeah, so that's the thing, is this is where it's really starting to become clear that while there are some new places and some different things, it's still Lordran.
Yeah.
This is still the place.
Mm-hmm.
And
then,
I mean,
like, I guess 100% then Drangleic was just, like, far away.
Yeah,
land.
Apparently it was just different, which I don't like. Again, this is talking about Dark Souls 2 lore, so of course I don't like it.
Yeah.
I would have much rather Dark Souls 2 lore have really been similar to this. But I guess the one thing is, because Dark Souls 2 lore was so shitty, the reveal is so much better in this game.
Yeah.
Where it's like, because, like, the thing is, like, even though you are, like, at Anorlondo and going towards Anorlondo, it's not just Anorlondo the level again. Like,
yeah.
It's not just exactly the same. Like, it's... This game does callbacks and building on the lore in a very right fashion.
Yeah.
And it works with the cyclical nature and how part of this is supposed to be a way to maybe end everything.
Yeah. It's like... I gotta get down there.
Well, actually, you're actually going to kind of be going up-ish,
yeah.
But essentially, that's a shortcut.
Yeah. It does not open from the side.
And once you're done whatever you're doing, you can just run by these guys, because you'll be going in a building and away from them.
Yeah.
So you won't have to worry about them fireballing you in the back once you run past them.
The small ones all die.
Yeah, they're just shit. Shit beacons are
shit.
Do shit.
Shitty beacons
in
the shit.
Yeah.
Alright.
I don't remember that giant dropping anything that good. It's up to you. I mean, your soul stack's over there.
I just want to punch him more.
That's fine. I mean, I also agree on, fight all the things always. Yeah, just watch him. He's more mobile.
Oh, did I miss one?
Fuck it, apparently. Oh, is he just dead?
Yeah,
just dead. He's just shit. I forgot how shit he was.
He's a little baddie. Yeah, but then, so I guess, just Anorlondo merged into Ithril one day.
Yeah, or if Ithril was just built upon it,
Yeah.
Part of it crumbled. Yeah, so, no, don't do it. Don't turn around. Don't go to the corner.
Go to this corner?
Hit that wall.
Oh, God, is there just
the other wall.
The other
wall.
The other wall. This wall. Oh, fuck off.
So, get ready. I recommend luring one.
Preparing my asshole.
I recommend luring one.
Oh, it's more of the crocogators.
There's two of them. The other one you can't see right now. And I'm only telling you because it's a fucked encounter.
Yes.
I recommend luring one over here because if you get too far out there, whatever, they'll both aggro. And okay, you got him good. It's not great to fight two of those things at once.
Nope.
One is very manageable. Two, not so great. Yeah, try and keep him in this corner, because if you get too far out into the center there,
gaping vagina dragon.
Oh, okay.
He just AoEs the ground.
Yes, however, it only hits in front of him. Mm-hmm. So if you can get behind him, you can just whack him. But yeah, so they hit a little bit harder than the first one.
They're kind of gaping dragon-esque.
A little bit, yeah. They have, like, the rib cage exposed and all that bullshit. Yeah, so they hit a little bit harder than the first two. Also, you can just run past those deacons now.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they hit a little bit harder. and you don't want to fight two of them, but they're manageable.
Yeah.
It's just a pain. But yeah, try to keep him in that corner, which unfortunately sucks for you, because you have to fight him in a corner and dodge in a corner. But if you get into the center there, you aggro the other one. And it's just, that's it. It's, ugh. Yeah, definitely an encounter I dislike. It's just, it's a fucking pain.
Yeah. But, you know.
And then, well, I mean, once you kill one, then it's not a big deal, because you can just fight the other one in a big open area.
But they're sticky candlesticks.
I know.
What? He really wanted it.
Yeah, he wanted it real good.
Mm-hmm. He was A plus for effort.
Yeah, right.
Oh, what the fuck happened, man? Oh yeah, and the moon is out over there.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Oh, Quindlin got it. Oh, man. I can't get over that.
Just wait. Oh, man, the rawest. You'll find out more about it. It's the rawest. That's the best part about DS3 is the theme is just that everyone got fucked. Like, more so than usual.
I want to know how hard Frampt and Kath and them all got it. Right. Everyone got it super hard. He's totally baby dragon. Like, the head and shit.
But yeah,
Shaping dragon have babies.
Or some shit. But, yeah, so here's the thing about this guy. Like, he hits hard and he's kind of obnoxious, but man, do I love the design of this enemy. Oh,
yeah.
Get it. Done. There you go.
I like the duck and stuff, fur shit going on.
Yeah, and because, like, the physics engine is better, like, you've got, like, the fur physics a little bit.
Yeah.
It's not quite Witcher 3 hair works.
Ooh.
But,
Geralt's beard grows in real time.
Oh my god, it's so cool. I don't want to talk about it. I could talk for hours about that shit. Yeah, you know how to fight these fucking guys. It's not a problem.
Ow.
So the cool thing about that attack that I like, that circle attack, is I don't really use visual cues. I use his, sucks. I use his growl. I use an audio cue.
Yo, yeah.
Oh, so that's the thing. That's what I've always loved about the Souls games.
Are they unique enemies, right?
Yes. Okay. They don't respawn. The other one will not be there. These are actually the last two you'll fight in the game.
Yay.
There's only three of them. But yeah, they are.
Baby gaping dragons, we hardly knew ye.
But I love the sound design in Souls games
so
much, because it's so well done. And that's why, like, I tried to, like, make a recording set so we can hear the fucking game while we do this.
Yeah.
Because it really matters to have, like, the sound when you play these fucking games. There's a crazy fucking, like, ballista section in Demon Souls.
Yeah.
And the easiest way to be able to dodge it, because it's, like, rapid fire, like, 1, 2, 3 repeatedly,
yeah,
is audio cue.
Yeah.
Like, the second you can't hear it, you're fucked.
Yeah.
But yeah, with the branching path, you deal good enough damage. They're basically, like, the same difficulty. Because you aren't really going to, aside from, like, crystal lizards and random stuff, you aren't actually going to get chunks until a couple areas from now.
Now anyway,
so,
yeah.
So, your weapon being where it's at's pretty fucking good.
Yeah. There's still a good amount of shit to go.
Yeah, you still got, you got this area and two more before you get to an area where you start getting chunks.
All right, shout out to you. The littlest beeping dragon.
Yes. That you have to dodge real late on that, because he tracks pretty well.
You ain't gonna see something like this in Last Order anytime soon.
Yeah, fucking right.
This fucking undead hell beast. Oh my god, that attack! Continuous hitbox on this.
Yeah, you gotta dodge right when the lunge starts.
Yeah.
And then, and the thing is that
and
one...
And dodge away from where his...
Yeah. And the other thing is, that one in particular, I noticed, that one and the other one, they like to do the double. So, like, they'll do it, and then you'll have a couple seconds, and you gotta dodge again, because they'll do it again.
Yeah.
Try.
I would not want one of these things as a pet.
Oh, fuck no. Are you kidding me? These things are fucking insane, huh? Yeah, cool. you got a repostable state.
Yeah, they're totally gaping dragons.
Yeah, they look just like, they have like the features.
Ring of flavor,
yep.
But not of protection.
No, only of flavor.
Oh. Does it do the same thing? A ring symbolizing the favor of the goddess Fina, whose fateful beauty is mentioned in legend. True to the fickle nature of Fina's favor, her ring increases max HP, stamina, and maximum equip load. But what's the gimmick?
It breaks.
When you take it off. Okay, it doesn't just say that, though. But it does all the shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Fuck it.
I flavor and protection all the time.
Hey, fuck it. You know I need to take that off.
Yeah. I got 4 slots.
Yeah, exactly. You've got 4
of them. I got 4 slots.
Yeah, so that's where you join the Aldrich Faithful Covenant.
Oh, over here by this big fat...
One of the Archdeacons.
Oh, this is the other...
Archdeacon
McDonald. Yeah, this
McDonald.
Is McDonald. Oh, he got it hard. Speaking of getting it hard.
Yeah, look at that shit.
Fucking eyes got ripped out or some shit. And... Okay. Is there any downside to joining it?
No.
Yeah, you just get the...
There's no downside to joining any covenants because they're items you put on.
Yeah. But I mean, like quests.
Oh, no. Shit. I would have told you.
And then you give human dregs to Aldrich to eat.
Yeah, I would have told you if it would have fucked something up.
Yeah, okay. Well, I thought he was going to be a boss or something, but...
Nope, just Covenant, man.
Huh. He got it hard.
Yeah, so there's a bonfire in here now.
Yeah.
Which is cool for the next section.
Yeah.
So yeah, if you want to...
Yeah, let's,
second.
Also, what am I at, soul-wise? Let's go back to Firelink. I can probably pop some continuals and get a level up, too, so...
Yeah.
And do that real quick.
Yeah, you go ahead and make your phone call. Yeah, well, you know.
Sucks.
The Pat one is it's pretty funny.
You fucked up. You're only worse than Hitler.
And then he's just like, darn.
Darn.
I at least appreciate Pat's fucking snarky attitude towards that shit.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, people give him way too much shit.
Well, that's what I've noticed. Everybody who, like, has a following doing DS3 LPs are catching so much shit. Just about everything. All right, so you're eating souls. I'm going to fill for time. Did you hear that the new Battlefield is going to be Battlefield 1?
Yeah, I saw that and was very confused.
Yeah, I mean, see, it takes place in World War 1. Isn't that cute? Huh? Is it?
I mean, A, yes, being in World War One is, like, super cool. I'm about that.
Yeah, well, I'm into that.
But
this naming convention of sticking the number or the word one on the end of things in a series that aren't the first one?
Yeah. You want to play Battlefield 1? Yeah, I'll play Battlefield 1. Wait, what game is this? This is Battlefield 1. No, I thought you meant the first
Original Battlefield.
Because they didn't learn their lesson with Xbox One.
Jesus fucking Christ. They better have the balls to stick with it, and the next console better be an Xbox 2.
The Xbox 2. Oh, no, you know that's just not going to happen.
Well, yeah, because it's going to be something stupid.
Is there anything else to
get? No, I'm pretty sure you're good to just move on.
Okay.
So, Dom, you remember in Dark Souls 1 when you go to Anor Londo and you have to run up narrow pathways with a Silver Knight shooting Dragon Slayer bows at you? Are you ready to run up narrow pathways with Silver Knight shooting Dragon Slayer bows at you?
They're still there, huh?
Oh, yeah. Well, you fought a couple earlier.
Yeah. We will never abandon our duty of standing on ledges shooting arrows.
Shooting fucking lances.
Yeah.
Like, they're fucking lances. It's absurd.
Oh, what assholes. I can't believe he did this. I can't believe he just did it again. Ugh.
The hardest part of Dark Souls 1! Yeah. It's actually not nearly as bad in this one.
Great. Yeah, it's a...
Snake Eater!
Oh, there's a lot of big ladders in this game.
Yeah, they really upped the large ladder count.
Alright. Well, I'm glad I got a big fucking shield.
Yes, actually, it's a very good thing. Yeah, I think there's something knocking about. Oh, there it is.
That's just the sign. Ooh, nice.
Just hanging out. Don't worry about it.
Wait, do I... Now do I have...
You need
I
four.
I need one more. Yeah,
yeah, you need one more.
Oh, God, I hear them.
Yeah, you could hear it.
Oh, they're so angry. Oh, it's literally the same setup.
Yeah.
Is there two of them?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, it's not so bad in that. It's not... there's another one.
Yeah, there's that side. There's a...
Oh,
there's
Jesus.
That side.
Oh, God. Oh, jeez. Oh, God.
Not
oh,
again. Jesus. For oh, real this time. Yeah, so the other way that you're not going, there's an item.
Oh, so this is actual progression.
Yeah, well...
Oh, God.
Yeah, they also switch to swords. This
and
is...
I can't even just kick him off the ledge or make
no,
him fall off
they,
himself.
No, they wised up.
They
yeah.
They upped their tech compared
little
to
bit.
Last time. So in some ways it's worse, and in some ways better.
Yes.
Okay, that's manageable, I guess. Good thing I got an ultra and I don't bounce off of walls.
Yeah, right? Yeah, so that way to your left,
yeah,
there, this... go down that path for an item, then you can continue forward.
Yeah.
See, luckily you just have hyper armor for days.
Oh, I thought he was gonna hop.
Oh, that would have been hilarious.
Oh,
fuck.
I missed. And then I clipped to the floor, don't worry about it.
Yeah, well.
Oh, right to the face!
Oh, Magnus man.
Magnus is so fucking strong.
Look at him just eating it. Look at him go. That's some goddamn Gogmazio's bullshit. Just eating the giant fucking thing.
Giant lance to the face. No problem. Why not?
I guess they don't.
Oh! Oh God!
Yeah, so you want to get that item, and then the other pathway opens up that shortcut gate to the pontiff, so... Yeah.
God damn it, Miyazaki!
The good old days! Now you have to climb up that really long ladder again. Oh my God, so let me tell you. The last... Oh man, so my last playthrough that I played through this part... I joined Aldrich Faithful, and I threw the Covenant item on. Let me tell you, if you auto-invade on the ladder, when you come back, you're at the bottom.
Ugh.
So, like, I would get, like, halfway up, auto-invade at the bottom, get halfway up, pick someone else up.
Ugh.
It took me, like, four invasions to get up the fucking ladder.
Ugh. Fuck. Ugh. Fuck everything about this place so far. It's the roughest.
Yeah. A little bit.
The theme of, Ethereal of the Boreal Valley.
The rawest deals.
Get the rawest.
Get the rawest deals.
The rawest and hardest.
Yeah, you can actually just jump over for the item here, by the way.
That's kind of cool.
You can actually just little hop.
Shark.
It's just a shark.
Yeah, it's just a shark. Yeah, so you can get up here and go to the left now. And there's a couple. You can get that item. I think that might be ashes. But I don't quite remember.
The ashes of a god.
Yeah, Easter's. This also, for the record, for your glorious Nippon Steel playthrough, that's the ashes that lets you buy the washing pole.
Oh, smart.
So you're aware.
Does it just say time is convoluted?
Time is convoluted.
Umbra Ash of an armor merchant from Eastern Rand. Shuri handmade a fire ink shine can turn this into few new things. Merchant captain of Crayon of Hunters was fascinated with my... Oh, so it's, what's his name? The Jura's from fucking... Bloodborne. What was his name? I never fucked with that covenant enough to actually talk to him. I know who it is, though. It's the guy who gets obsessed about having the Chaos Blade or whatever, right?
Yeah, what is his name? God damn it, I know this.
It's like Shiva?
Shiva of the East, that's what it is. It's Shiva of the East. Why couldn't I remember that?
Allegiant to the royals of old, it said that even after the family's passing, the knights continue to watch over their manor and the ruined cathedral. So yeah, they're all dead now.
Yeah, they're all fucked.
That looks nice as shit.
Oh yeah, the silver knight armor
looks
really good.
A lot better than the black knight armor.
Yeah, it looks really good.
Black knight looks pretty cool, but...
The black knight armor looks really badass,
yeah.
But the silver knight armor just looks good.
Yeah. Okay, I promise not to step off the edge of this line. Oh, they're just aiming each other with assholes.
Yeah, the Silver Knights are, like they're not, like, easy in Dark Souls 1, but they feel a little more difficult in this game,
yeah. Oh, they seem to punch a lot harder.
Oh, fuck yeah. Well, their weapons are fucking... Ah, fuck.
just got killed with that guy in the back.
That's funny. Well, their weapons now have that lightning on it, which helps a lot. And the thing about infused weapons with like fire and lightning, or unique weapons like that do like lightning damage or something.
Yeah.
From a PvP standpoint, they have a very good quality in doing that, because while doing a straight damage is better for your overall AR.
Yeah.
The split damage is good because you get almost guaranteed chip damage through shields.
Yeah. And not everyone's going to be specced for that kind of resistance.
Oh, fuck no.
So.
Yeah.
Thank you for that, boss. Can't believe he brought back the fucking arrow corridor just to be a dick.
It's so funny.
Miyazaki's just laughing to himself. Ha 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 ha, so funny.
Yeah, it's way more manageable to go up this side.
You are a right fucking person.
Yeah, they'll de-aggro and go back to bow, so if you're gonna poise them or get out of their range, you don't actually have to fight all of them.
I didn't hyper armor.
Yeah, it's the thing about hyper armor, that's
eat
good.
A dick!
The thing about hyper armor that's a little wonky is you have to be really precise on knowing when your hyper armor
the exact
starts.
Frames, yeah.
At least the hitboxing on arrows is so good that you can like dodge them properly now. As opposed to Dark Souls 1, where there was no hope.
Yeah. Just gotta put on a big fucking shield and hope for the best.
Alright, yeah, so... you're getting close to it. Yeah, look at that sneaky fucker over there. Yeah, what the fuck happened here, man? Nice, that was good. Nice setup there.
Of course I got his chest plate again.
Well, yeah.
Not any other part.
You play Monster Hunter, you know how this works.
Where's the Duke's archives?
The Duck's archives.
Where's Seath the Jobless?
Seath is dead and you know it.
No, but I mean like his reincarnation. His re-reincarnation.
His re-reincarnation. Well, he wasn't even really reincarnated in the bullshit Dark Souls 2 lore. He just had a soul for some reason.
Yeah.
Because, you know, those dragons who don't have souls.
Yeah.
He has a soul now, don't worry about it. It's like they didn't even read that, like, the soul you get from it.
Yeah.
From the first game is a bequeathed Lord soul from Gwyn, like the fragment of Gwyn's soul.
Yeah.
It's like, no, Seath had a soul. Yeah. You got it.
You got a sword. Swords are our spears, kind of.
Yeah.
I mean, his spear does just have a sword on it.
Oh,
you got a counter
here. Oh boy.
Fuck, boy. Fucking Christ.
Yeah, right down the path he was standing on leads to that
shortcut.
Shortcut,
yeah.
And then you can
just
progress.
Beating it super hard.
Yeah, well, the Silver Knights are pretty tough. There's not like a whole shitload of them, but like they hit hard.